Sorry, Sam. I can't fix the jukebox here. I gotta take it back to the shop and open her up. I'll go get the guys.
Take it back to the shop, my foot. That's the biggest ploy in a fix-it racket, Sammy. You know, they tell you that just so they can jack up the price on you. Trust me. All this baby needs is one swift, good... Shop time.
Well, what are we gonna do without our jukebox?
Place won't be the same.
No jukebox? I feel naked.
Excuse me, why are you all mourning the temporary loss of this jukebox? I mean, you never play it.
No, 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 Frasier. The point is, it's the perfect height to lean on. Take a look at what it does to the line of my body there. Perfect pickup post, man.
Hi.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I just demonstrated. I'll talk to you later.
All right, Sam. But you never play it.
Sam, I should have her back in a week, good as new.
Week? How can we live without our juke for a week? Now, don't you have a loaner or something?
I'm all out of jukeboxes. How about a cigarette machine?
No, we'd never use that.
You never use the jukebox!
Hey, if you want, I could loan you a karaoke machine. Here we go, Sam. Your karaoke machine and some song catalogs to go along with it.
Oh, great. Just what we need, a loud, abrasive, noise-making machine.
Oh, perhaps I passed judgment too quickly here. This may have some merit in it. It's filled with old standards. It's got someone to watch over me, all of me. You made me love you.
How does this song end?
I don't know. I think it just kind of keeps going till one of us drops.
This is the silliest, dopiest display we've ever witnessed. And if you want to make a pop, you do it like this.
Okay, everybody, give me your attention. A couple of the guys have put together a song for the future Mrs. Colcord. Hit it.
Excuse me. And it goes for something like this. Isn't it romantic? Music in the night, a dream that can be heard. Isn't it romantic? Moving shadows make the oldest magic work.
It is a lovely song when sung properly.
Killjoy.
Isn't it romantic merely to be young?
Shut up and leave me alone!
Hey, would you cut me some slack? I've had no formal training.
Hey there, who? You with the stars in your eyes.
Are you talking to me?
I've never made a fool of you.
Frasier, it's been 2 days. I think it's time you stopped.
In the middle of my salute to Adler and Ross? I think not.
Hey there, you on that high.
It's a dangerous combination. A karaoke machine and an obsessive personality whose parents used to play Broadway cast albums to drown out their lovemaking.
I hear singing and there's no one there. I smell coming. All day long I seem to walk on air. I wonder why.
Lilith, please get him off the damn karaoke. He's been on there for 3 days. Just make him stop.
Hey, you know him better than anybody else. There's got to be something you can do.
I can only think of one thing, but it's pretty drastic.
Anything.
I wonder why.
You don't need advising. It is not so surprising that you feel very strange.
Look who thinks she's Edie Gourmet.
Yeah, she's got a nice set of pipes for a shrink, eh?
Yeah. Hey, guys, listen up for a second, will you?
Fellas.
Always leave them wanting more.
Like lightning, riding from the rifles of the IRA.
Isn't it romantic? Music in the night. Oh, I'm sorry, I was singing too loud.
No, not at all. I can't tell you how much I'm enjoying hearing it.
Careful. Doesn't take much coaxing to get me to perform.
Really?
Oh, yes. Get a glass of wine and me before you know it, I'm serenading the entire room.
Really?
Oh, I'm afraid I have a bit of the old ham in me. Would it be presumptuous to sing in front of your guests?
Well, I think we could persuade the piano player to play it again.
Excuse me, everyone. I just want to thank you all for this warm welcome to KACL. And as a token of my gratitude, I'd like to share this song with you.
Clint, there's been a little change in plan.
Yes. I'm going to be your accompanist now. Get out.
Isn't it romantic? Music in the night, a dream that can't be heard. Isn't it romantic?
Please,
moving
everybody.
Shadows right.
Nobody's perfect.
The oldest magic.
My old friend Willie's dragging me out again tonight. I could really use a buffer. He's taking me to some god-awful karaoke bar.
Are you gonna sing?
No.
Okay, I'll go.
Really, you will?
Well, I have a babysitter tonight. My plans fell through. Oh. Karaoke might be fun.
All right.
Karaoke? Tonight? Oh, I'd love to.
Well, Gil, I'm not sure you'd enjoy this.
Oh, nonsense. If we go to the one on Pike, I keep a locker there. I store my own microphone and shoe jackets.
Hey, guys. Hi, Ross.
Oh, I know.
I see you're at our table.
Our table? Ooh, is there an office romance brewing?
No, Gil. We're just friends, right, Noel?
So far.
Well, who knows what the night has in store? We're all going for karaoke. Why don't you join us?
Count me in.
Is that my beeper?
I didn't hear anything.
Oh, my God.
Ross.
It's my babysitter. She only calls when it's an emergency. I have to go. Bye.
Ross.
Taxi!
Ross, wait!
Ross, wait!
Well, looks like it's just us boys.
Hey, Frasier.
Turn off the music.
Oh, well, we were just...
Dad, I never want to hear music again.
Oh, I take it you had a whiz-bang time at the karaoke bar?
For starters, Woody sang What Kind of Fool Am I? Quickly turned into an audience participation number. Then Gil and Noel did a charming duet of Anything You Can Do, I Can Do Better. They were both wrong. I guess the highlight of the evening was when Gil, after one too many Kir Royales, performed a haunting rendition of I Feel Pretty. During the latter verses of which, Noel joined him on the apron of the stage and translated into Klingon. Well, I think I'm just gonna go off to bed so I can get up bright and early for my harbor cruise with Woody tomorrow. Thank you.
Hey, baby, I hear the blues are calling. Toss salads and scrambled eggs. Mercy. And maybe I seem a bit confused. Well, maybe, but I got you pegged. But I don't know what to do with those tossed salads and scrambled eggs. They're calling again. Thank you!
I know I stand in line until I think you have the time to spend an evening with me.
And if we go someplace to dance, I know that there's a chance you won't be leaving with me.
Then afterwards we drop into a quiet little place and have a drink or two. And then I go and spoil it all by saying something stupid like, I love you. And then I went and spoiled it all by doing something stupid like explode you.